just earlier, the fans on their feet as the national anthem rang out throughout the arena. Hello and welcome, everyone, to another exciting edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Joined in the booth with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr, this is Kevin Harlan. It's Chicago taking on the Seattle Supersonics. Quick check now at the starting lineups for both teams. A factor in every game, Michael Jordan will be on display.
And Kevin, what stands out to me is his array of moves down on the low block. The low post scoring, back to the basket game. That's what he does, and that's a valuable weapon for a team to have.
And Steve, very few players have his finishing ability. We see him get a lot of and ones because even if he draws hard contact, he is able to play through that and typically score.
And it's Chicago to start out. Passes to Pippen, launches it. That is good.
And they get on the board first.
Looking to set the tone early.
Payton drives in, rejected by Long. Left side, Jordan. No luck. Good D by Payton.
That's not an opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Inside to Kemp. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton.
The easiest way to do it sometimes is with the bounce pass.
So it's Chicago now. Jordan up top. He's covered by Hawkins. Chicago on defense. First quarter of play, 1 minute played. Here's Kemp, and he finishes nicely on the layup. Kemp's got his second basket.
Very nice pickup of the offensive rebound. And once he gets his hands on it, you know it's going back up and back in.
Terrific defensive play to cut him off and square up.
And he took a shot. Excellent toughness to get in there and make a play. I love that kind of work.
Here's Seattle. Payton with the ball. And it's blocked by Jordan. Left side, Jordan. Shot on the wing. They get it back, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Yeah, the referee's all over that one.
No doubt about it. Clearly a foul. Nothing to argue about there.
Bulls shooting their first free throws of this game, and he can't get the first one. And he sinks the second. And we're about a minute and a half into the first quarter. Hawkins against Jordan. A shot by Johnson, no good.
Boy, he may find himself on the bench pretty soon if he continues to miss shots like that.
That's good. Pippen's got five now.
Even though it went down, I don't think that's the kind of look they should be settling for.
Payton passes to Shrimp. Johnson with a screen on Pippen. It's hauled in by Longley.
Boy, he really bungled that finish.
Back to Jordan. Let's it fly from 18. And it's Chicago scoring again.
Don't take your eyes off of him because he can make plays from multiple spots on the floor. Put the isolated cam on him.
Hawkins kicks to Payton. Up top, Kemp. Here's Johnson. Bank shot. No good. The 11-footer and Scottie Pippen again. Pippen's got 7 points in the game.
Well, he's off to a good start, and he's a guy who we know. I mean, if he gets going early, he can give you problems all day.
It's blocked. Hawkins against Jordan. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Bulls shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. And he knocks down the first one. Wennington, he's checked in for Chicago. And so Jordan nails both of them. Sonics trail by eight. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Well, he's found his game and his rhythm this quarter. He's gotten into a nice groove.
Kemp's gotten three of his five shots to go here. The drive by Jordan makes good on the step-back jumper. Jordan's got 6 points. And here are the Supersonics now. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Thank you, Kevin. I caught up with the Sonics head coach. I asked him about the challenge of defending this team, and he said, quote, it really comes down to their awareness offensively. They don't take a lot of bad shots or make those kind of mental errors, and that puts the pressure on us to be just as efficient. We've got to value our possessions so we can match them shot for shot. Gentlemen, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. It all sounds like a very solid plan given the shooters they have to contend with here, guys.
Yeah, he's aware of what their strength is, and he knows that they need to focus on stopping those guys.
Or at least limiting the damage they can do, Steve. Make it tough for them. Don't give them any easy opportunities. That, to me, might be a more realistic goal.
Here is Kerr after the made shot from Perkins.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
No, that's for sure, because this guy's too good of a shooter to miss that look consistently.
Askew passes to Perkins. Can't get it to go. And it's Chicago the other way. Now Kukoc. The shot misses. Nice D from McMillan. Rakowski. And they will get the basket here, folks, as they rule goaltending.
He almost got to that shot in time, but not quite. You can't touch the ball once it's on the way down.
8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Pass to Simpkins. Right at the free throw line. And it's off the back rim. No good. Sonics trail by four. Here's McMillan. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Now here's Perkins from 13. The basket there by Sam Perkins.
And they have to mix it up defensively. That was just too easy.
Now Kerr. Takes a three.
Oh, he got it!
Oh, buzzer! Knock it down!
Shot
right at the horn.
Boy, ends the quarter with a dead-eye three as the buzzer sounds.
They had that set up, I think, Steve, and he timed it perfectly.
No shortage of scoring here at the end of the first quarter. Bulls lead by five. And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And taking a look at Chicago's performance here, Clark and Steve, what have they been doing or not doing?
And how about the defense, guys? They have really controlled the lane with their shot blocking.
Yeah, excellent defense there. Every shot has either been altered or rejected.
Gary Payton is out there with Hawkins. Then there's Sean Kemp. Then there's Perkins. And it's Shrimp in at the small forward position. They're the group for Seattle starting the second.
Well, as far as jump shots go, that's as high percentage as it gets.
I'm not sure how that didn't go down.
Perkins with the bucket.
You know, passing the ball well on the perimeter has really opened things up offensively for this club.
Steve, it makes the game easy. I mean, 10 straight points off assist. That's impressive, but it's easy when you move the ball.
Rejected by Jordan. And there's the pass to Shrimp. Another shot. He lays it in. Shrimp's got his first 2 points.
Boy, they are just destroying them in the paint.
You could say that again, Steve. The defenders just aren't aggressive enough down low.
The drive by Jordan. Pass to Harper. Outside Pippen. But three. Seattle grabs the miss. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Kemp kicks to Perkins. Rejected by Longley. And here is Rodman. Pippen for three. Perkins pulls it in.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Perkins with a screen on Harper. Payton kicks to Shrimp. It's stolen by Rodman. Here's Jordan, and he gets it to go. Jordan's got 8 points.
Can't pass up that kind of look.
Passes it to Hawkins. And that one's good.
You know, of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is major smash-mouth basketball, guys.
Love it. Old school. Just physical play in the paint. Dominate.
Here's Jordan. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. 10 points for him.
That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
Payton drives in. Boy, Gary Payton there with a heck of a move. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Jordan inside. He's covered by Hawkins. And Jordan gets it to go.
A large part of what they've been able to do here is centered around his offense.
Payton against Harper. Payton kicks to Kemp. Pass to Hawkins from downtown. It's all in by the Bulls. Rodman's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Jordan dishes to Harper. Rebound by the Sonics. Payton's got his third rebound tonight. To the inside. There's the killer two-handed slam. Stupendous rush to the rim and a mighty slam on the end of it.
But through the teeth of some pretty soft D. Can't help but say this.
Well, let's see how that impacts things here, because those kinds of plays sometimes can be game changers on both sides.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Well, Kevin, I was able to listen in on what the head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over in his huddle. He said, we're missing out on second chance points. He wants them going hard to the offensive glass for the rest of this game. Thing he touched on was the physical aspect of this contest. He wants his guys using their strength and muscle to make things happen. Guys, they're clearly hoping those changes have an effect even before this game makes it to halftime. Kevin?
All right, Doris, thanks. And now we'll get a perspective here on the hustle game, how it's been going for the Bulls.
Well, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
And they're getting out in transition, too, finding some easy points on the fast break.
It's tipped. Here's Jordan. Lays it up and banks it in. Jordan's got the game tied up here for the Bulls.
And he's made the most of his chances, hasn't he? Really needs to continue to work for those good looks.
Here's the screen. The dish to Johnson. Here's Schrempf. Off target from outside.
Yeah, no excuses there. Got a really good look at the basket after being freed up by the pick.
We say it all the time. The execution was excellent. The result not as good, but good ball movement anyway.
And it's Steve Kerr knocking it down from long range.
You know what, guys? He can really light it up from the perimeter at times.
McMillan passes to Schrempf. Kerr against McMillan.
Probably should hold for one shot here. Clock is on their side.
Yeah, no brainer. They can hold it for the last shot.
Back to Jordan. With the fadeaway. A beautiful fadeaway jumper by Jordan.
They can't seem to do anything to slow him down.
Yeah, this is a scoring clinic. I mean, he's got it going on.
And we're through two here and a good one. In Chicago, they're up by five. We're going to step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after our halftime.
Now, presented by Sprint.
Welcome to 2K Sports. It's been a great Sunday of basketball so far. Chicago with the lead against Seattle. Tremendous defensive effort out there. They're challenging every shot, sending them into the third row. An unbelievable half from Michael Jordan. High percentage looks in the first half. Amazing work from the field, shooting in the high 60s. That's big time bucket buying. And this dedicated Sonics team is weathering the storm. A dramatic advantage in the paint. They're getting right in close and converting the kind of buckets they want. They felt the impact of Sam Perkins. He's picked up half a dozen points and also helped out with two rebounds. That will be all for us. Thanks for stopping in. We'll see you next time.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. What a game we're seeing from Michael Jordan.
Yeah, it's been a lockdown defensive effort from him through the first two quarters. He's just swatting shots away.
Well, the reach and the timing he's shown to get to some of these shots has been really impressive. He looks like he has telescope arms out there. He's like an octopus.
Taking a look at the Bulls. We've got Longley. Dennis Rodman is out there with Pippen. And it's Michael Jordan. And it's Harper in at the point. Jordan kicks to Harper. Fires it up. No good. Payton with some nice D. Sonics trail by three. Rejected by Pippen. And they're able to recover. Seattle shooting their first shots from the stripe in this game.
Two shots.
And that one falls for Kemp. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Fast break, here comes Chicago. Here's Pippen. He drains the quick shot. Pippen's got 9 points. Payton against Harper. That's tipped. Payton with the ball. Here's the teardrop, and it's good on the layup. Payton's got his second basket of the game.
Guys, that time you went for the fancy finish for us there, man. That was sweet.
Hawkins against Jordan. Pippen for three. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Jordan. Jordan's got 3 assists now in this one. Pippen's gone 5 of 7 from the field. That's over 71% action. To the paint. Here's Schrempf. Rodman grabs the miss. Rodman's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Out of bounds, Bulls ball, Chicago keeps possession.
Maybe a low percentage pass, but it still nearly got through.
I like it, though. I mean, it's an aggressive play. Heads up defending to deflect it away.
Sam Perkins, he's checked in for Johnson. No good from Jordan. Sonics trail by 5. Payton drives in. Oh, and it looks like that's going to be a goaltending call. Yep, that's it. So they'll get the best.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
Chicago calls timeout. And as with any timeout at this point of the game, important to go over the strategies that are working and those that are needed in terms of adjustments. And, of course, the opportunity, guys, to get hydrated with Gatorade for coming back onto the floor. We've seen some good action so far, and there's more of it to come.
Yeah, this game has been physical, it's been fast, it's been high-paced. So anytime you're in a situation like this where it's really a hard-fought game, critical to keep yourself hydrated throughout.
Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Well, Kevin, I was able to listen in on what the head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over in his huddle. He told them that their commitment to offensive rebounding needs to be much stronger. He said transition defense shouldn't be the focus. It should be getting to the offensive boards. He also wants them to play very physically. Impose your will on them, he said. Let them know who they're up against. Those are likely not the last adjustments they make today, guys. There's still time left in this one. Back to you, Kevin.
And thank you, Doris. The Sonics have shot 2 free throws, and they're 1 of 2 so far.
Shooting from Seattle, Declan Schrempf.
That one misses. Chicago leading by 4. From the free throw line, Michael Jordan soaring to the hoop. And Jordan gets it to go.
Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
Payton against Harper. No good from Payton.
I think the game plan needs to change here, guys, if they're going to get out of the hole, because he is not helping their offense.
Ripped away. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
Guys, that's simply superb. Ball pressure, a run out, and then a dunk in transition.
Exactly, Clark, what they wanted, the aggressive defense to lead to.
Yeah, points in transition.
Yeah, that's why you want to make the other team feel uncomfortable handling the ball, because you can get easy points out of it at the other end.
Here's Pippen, and he uses both hands to jam it in.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
Well, now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. Here's Payton. Lays it in without an inch of room around him. Payton's got 8 points here in this quarter.
All the points these defenders are allowing inside is inexcusable. It's five baskets in a row, and they've all been practically lay-ins.
Yeah, they've got to harden and toughen up down there, guys.
Harper's shot's good.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Clark.
And the first timeout of the game called for Seattle. We've seen Michael Jordan really having a great game.
He's on fire. And they needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hands.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Kevin, thank you. Head coach of the Sonics had some words for his team over the break. The one point he really drove home was that defensively, they have to do a better job of taking away the outside shot. They're going to be dedicating more manpower to the perimeter from now on. Probably a good time to make some changes with a good chunk of the second half still to go, Kevin.
Thank you, Doris. Fades. That's good. Kemp's got nine. Chicago leading by seven. Feeds to Jordan. It's hauled in by the Sonics. There's 57 seconds left in the third quarter. And stolen by Jordan.
Oh, how about that basketball, man?
Boy, extremely opportunistic defense leading to those points there.
That dunk, Clark, coming within seconds of the steal.
Love the way they convert from defense to offense.
But that's what happens when you get all five guys on a string defensively ready to react and make a play.
And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Kia. Good stuff on that Kia Slim King.
Major League big boy throwdown.
And he keeps a tight grip on that rim after the finish.
And maybe that'll give this team a little bit of their edge back.
And here's Kerr. He's got six from 13, and he's blocked by Perkins. Out to Kukoc. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by Hawkins. Sonics trail by seven. Six-second difference between shot and game clock. Steve Kerr comes up with the rebound. Outside Pippen. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. Bulls shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight. No good on the free throw. Bulls making a switch here. And he's good on the second. 11 seconds left to play in the third. McMillan passes to Kemp. No good. Bushler. He got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And offensively, a great show for the fans through the first three quarters. It's been a fun game to watch. Bulls lead by eight. And time for the short break, and stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. The points coming in bunches as we wrap up the third quarter. It's been a good one. And while we can now, let's take a look at today's State Farm assist of the game.
A tremendous point guard play, but that's nothing new coming from him. This is what you expect, the gorgeous feed there.
Chicago leading by eight. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. On the floor for Seattle. Jumpers out there with strength. Then it's Johnson. Then there's Payton. And it's Wingate in at the two. Outside, Kukoc lets the three fly. That drops. Kukoc has got the lead up to nine now for the Bulls.
Well, they haven't gotten much production from him, but they remain in the lead.
Chicago making some changes. Luke Longley's checked in for Simpkins, and it's Harper in for Bushler. First team. Outside Kemp. Kerr against Wingate. Schrempf kicks to Payton. Six to shoot. Here's Kemp. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton.
You know, tired legs can affect you at the defensive end, and I think that's what's happening right here.
I agree, because as much offense as we saw early, we're seeing even more of it here late.
Tell you what, he can be really frustrating as a shooter. All you can do is grimace because he just can't find the range.
Shrev passes to Wingate to the wing right side. The shot by Payton, and another basket for Seattle. Now Harper. The step back jumper is good. And the Bulls lead by 7. Guys, some great passing from them.
Yeah, it makes it tough for the defense to chase that ball around when it moves that crisply all over the court.
Yeah, it sure does, Clark. And look at the assist totals. They're piling up. I mean, this has been a nice game execution-wise for this club.
And, guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for Chicago?
Their defense has been outstanding, Kevin. Closing out on shots, blocking a lot of them as well.
And, Steve, we can't fail to mention all the steals they've piled up, too. I mean, that's making a big difference. They've really gotten into them defensively.
The Bulls making a switch here. Jordan's checked in.
He's done a much better job of getting to the line here, aggressively taking it inside and not shying away from contact. I thought he was settling a bit in the first.
Second shot opportunity. There's big Luke Longley cleaning things up inside.
Well, that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active, be energetic, and react as soon as the shot goes up.
Here's Hawkins. Misses from close range.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
The drive by Jordan. He dishes it to Harper. On the wing, Kukoc. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will retain possession. Jordan up top. He's covered by Hawkins.
No breathing room at all to take that shot.
He feeds it to Shrimp. Johnson dishes to Kemp. From 13, he hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Kemp's got 9 points here in the second half.
His shooting has been so good today. He may have to take it upon himself to try to get his club out of this hole.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Well, Kevin, I was able to listen in on what the head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over in his huddle. He told the players, let's put our foot on them and keep them down. We've got them exactly where we want them. I want to see you guys slow the pace, use the clock, and stay away from any silly fouls.
Here's Jordan. And the defense didn't have position. They whistle a blocking foul, and he'll go to the line.
Jordan having a terrific game. 22 points and a pair of blocks to go along with those.
Well, anytime they've needed him, he's come through defensively. He's made a major impact on this game.
He misses the free throw. Good on the second free throw. Time called here. The Sonics decide to talk it over. We've seen Michael Jordan really having a great game.
He's really taking it to him inside. They got to find a way to slow him down.
Here's Payton. This is to Shrimp. He kicks it to Johnson. Payton outside. The pass to Hawkins. Shoots the 3. Michael Jordan grabs the miss.
And his mechanics are just all out of whack now. He just has no feel for his shot.
Well, his numbers certainly back that fact up. I mean, he is going ice cold here. He sniffed out that board and then powered it back in.
Pure might, Clark. So strong going back up with that one.
That's exactly what he's capable of, guys. So strong.
Payton kicks to Shrimp. It's Hawkins on the wing, looking to get it going, and he sinks the layup. And now just a 3-point Chicago lead. And that bucket ignites the crowd.
Crucial bucket there, and you hear it in their reaction.
And you can feel the energy throughout this building right now. What a huge shot.
Here's Shrimp, and another basket for Seattle.
Oh, you gotta love this energy right now. They're getting hot right when they absolutely have to.
Time is of the essence here. I mean, they do not look like they're going to let down the intensity. Well, Jordan has been fantastic.
Chicago making a switch here. Pippen's checked in. Free throw good, Jordan.
Huge basket, and then the free throw was even bigger because now it becomes a two-possession lead.
Time called here. The Sonics decide to chalk it over. And they're behind by four. 59 seconds left in the fourth. Payton passes to Schrempf. And the shot falls short this time. Here's Jordan. Not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down. And the Bulls lead by six. Guys, a critical time for them in this ballgame.
No room for mistakes right now.
It's picked off. And here's the fast break. Jordan leading the way. The dunk and the foul. A powerhouse move. And he's got a chance for one more at the line. That's on Detlef Schrempf. Free throw good, Jordan.
And you got to think those free throws are the nail in the coffin, guys.
They're having trouble stopping this run.
Brown, the more trips they continue to come up empty, the more the pressure builds on them.
There's the bucket. Good. 26 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Shoots from the elbow. It's taken away by Peyton. Shoots. Yes! 5 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one, and an intentional foul right there. And no good is the first free throw missing for him. We'll see if he can nail the second. And he ends up making the second, and that increases their lead to six. Time called here. The Sonics decide to talk it over. They trail by six. Just 2 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what's your take?
Well, they can game plan all they want, but there's not enough time left for them to come back and win this game.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure exactly what they think they're going to pull off here.
And so it's Chicago winning this one. It was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
Well, it's time to say so long. For Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. Now it's time to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Michael Jordan.
For the fancy finish for us there, man. That was sweet.
Hawkins against Jordan. Pippen for three. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Jordan. Jordan's got three assists now in this one. Pippen's gone 5 of 7 from the field. That's over 71% accuracy. To the paint, here's Schrempf. Rodman grabs the miss. Rodman's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Out of bounds, Bulls ball, Chicago keeps possession.
Maybe a low percentage pass, but it still nearly got through.
I like it, though. I mean, it's an aggressive play. Heads up defending to deflect it away.
Sam Perkins, he's checked in for Johnson. No good from Jordan. Sonics trail by 5. Payton drives in. Oh, and it looks like that's going to be a goaltending call. Yep, that's it. So they'll get the basket.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
Chicago calls timeout. And as with any timeout at this point of the game, important to go over the strategies that are working and those that are needed in terms of adjustments. And, of course, the opportunity, guys, to get hydrated with Gatorade for coming back onto the floor. We've seen some good action so far, and there's more of it to come.
Yeah, this game has been physical. It's been fast. It's been high-paced. So anytime you're in a situation like this where it's really a hard-fought game, critical to keep yourself hydrated throughout.
Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Well, Kevin, I was able to listen in on what the head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over in his huddle. He told them that their commitment to offensive rebounding needs to be much stronger. He said transition defense shouldn't be the focus. It should be getting to the offensive boards. He also wants them to play very physically. Impose your will on them, he said. Let them know who they're up against. Those are likely not the last adjustments they make today, guys. There's still time left in this one. Back to you, Kevin.
And thank you, Doris. The Sonics have shot 2 free throws, and they're 1 of 2 so far.
Shooting from Seattle, Detlef Schrempf.
That one misses. Chicago leading by 4. From the free throw line, Michael Jordan soaring to the hoop, and Jordan gets it to go.
Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
Payton against Harper. No good from Payton.
I think the game plan needs to change here, guys, if they're going to get out of the hole, because he is not helping their offense.
Ripped away. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
Guys, that's simply superb. Ball pressure, a run out, and then a dunk in transition.
Exactly, Clark, what they wanted, the aggressive defense to lead to.
Yeah, points in transition.
Yeah, that's why you want to make the other team feel uncomfortable handling the ball, because you can get easy points out of it at the other end.
Here's Pippen, and he uses both hands to jam it in.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
Well, now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. Here's Payton. Lays it in without an inch of room around him. Payton's got 8 points here in this quarter.
All the points these defenders are allowing inside is inexcusable. It's 5 baskets in a row, and they've all been practically lay-ins.
Yeah, they've got to harden and toughen up down there, guys.
Harper's shot's good.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Clark.
And the first time out of the game called for Seattle. We've seen Michael Jordan really having a great game.
He's on fire. They needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hands.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Kevin, thank you. Head coach of the Sonics had some words for his team over the break. The one point he really drove home was that defensively, they have to do a better job of taking away the outside shot. They're going to be dedicating more manpower to the perimeter from now on. Probably a good time to make some changes with a good chunk of the second half still to go, Kevin.
Thank you, Doris. Fades. That's good. Kemp's got 9. Chicago leading by 7. Feeds to Jordan. It's hauled in by the Sonics. There's 57 seconds left in the third quarter. And stolen by Jordan.
Oh, how about that basketball, man? Beautiful. Wow.
Boy, extremely opportunistic defense leading to those points there.
That dunk, Clark, coming within seconds of the steal.
Love the way they convert from defense to offense.
But that's what happens when you get all five guys on a string defensively ready to react and make a play.
And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Kia. Good stuff on that Kia Slim King.
Major League big boy throwdown right there.
And he keeps a tight grip on that rim after the finish.
And maybe that'll give this team a little bit of their edge back.
And here's Kerr. He's got... Just earlier, the fans on their feet as the national anthem rang out throughout the arena. Hello and welcome, everyone, to another exciting edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Joined in the booth with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr, this is Kevin Harlan. It's Chicago taking on the Seattle Supersonics. Quick check now at the starting lineups for both teams. A factor in every game, Michael Jordan will be on display.
And Kevin, what stands out to me is his array of moves down on the low block. Low post scoring, back to the basket game. That's what he does, and that's a valuable weapon for a team to have.
And Steve, very few players have his finishing ability. We see him get a lot of and ones because even if he draws hard contact, he is able to play through that and typically score.
And in Chicago to start out. Passes to Pippen. Launches it. That is good.
And they get on the board first.
Looking to set the tone early.
Payton drives in. Rejected by Long. Outside Jordan. No luck. Good D by Payton.
That's not an opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Inside to Kemp. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton.
The easiest way to do it sometimes is with the bounce pass.
So it's Chicago now. Jordan up top. He's covered by Hawkins. Chicago on defense. First quarter of play, 1 minute played. Here's Kemp, and he finishes nicely on the way. Kemp's got his second basket.
Very nice pickup of the offensive rebound. And once he gets his hands on it, you know it's going back up and back in.
Terrific defensive play to cut him off and square up.
And he took a shot. Excellent toughness to get in there and make a play. I love that kind of work.
Here's Seattle. Payton with the ball, and it's blocked by Jordan. Left side, Jordan. Shot on the wing. They get it back, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Yeah, the referee's all over that one.
No doubt about it. Clearly a foul. Nothing to argue about there.
Bulls shooting their first free throws of this game, and he can't get the first one. And he sinks the second. And we're about a minute and a half into the first quarter. Hawkins against Jordan. A shot by Johnson, no good.
Boy, he may find himself on the bench pretty soon if he continues to miss shots like that.
That's good. Pippen's got five now.
Even though it went down, I don't think that's the kind of look they should be settling for.
Payton passes to Shrimp. Johnson with a screen on Pippen. It's hauled in by Longley.
Boy, he really bungled that finish.
Back to Jordan. Let's it fly from 18. And it's Chicago scoring again.
Don't take your eyes off of him because he can make plays from multiple spots on the floor. Put the isolated cam on him.
Hawkins kicks to Payton. Up top, Kemp. Here's Johnson. Bank shot, no good. the 11-footer, and Scottie Pippen again. Pippen's got 7 points in the game.
Well, he's off to a good start, and he's a guy who we know. I mean, if he gets going early, he can give you problems all day.
It's blocked. Hawkins against Jordan. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. The Bulls shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. And he knocks down the first one. Wennington, he's checked in for Chicago. And so Jordan nails both of them. Sonics trail by 8. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Well, he's found his game and his rhythm this quarter. He's gotten into a nice groove.
Kemp's gotten 3 of his 5 shots to go here. The drive by Jordan makes good on the step-back jumper. Jordan's got 6 points. And here are the Supersonics now. Let's catch up with 6 from 13. And he's blocked by Perkins. Out to Kukoc. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by Hawkins. Sonics trail by 7. 6-second difference between shot and game clock. Steve Kerr comes up with the rebound. Outside Pippen. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2. Bulls shooting their 7th and 8th attempts at the foul line tonight. No good on the free throw. Bulls making a switch here. And he's good on the 2nd. 11 seconds left to play in the 3rd. McMillan passes to Kemp. No good. Buechler. He got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And offensively, a great show for the fans through the first 3 quarters. It's been a fun game to watch. Bulls lead by 8. And time for the short break, and stay right where you are. The 4th quarter is coming up next. The points coming in bunches as we wrap up the 3rd quarter. It's been a good one. And while we can now, let's take a look at today's State Farm assist of the game.
A tremendous point guard play, but that's nothing new coming from him. This is what you expect, the gorgeous feed there.
Chicago leading by 8. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. 4th quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. On the floor for Seattle. Jumpers out there with Shrimp. Then it's Johnson. Then there's Peyton. And it's Wingate in at the 2. Outside, Kukoc lets the 3 fly. That drops. Kukoc has got the lead up to 9 now for the Bulls.
Well, they haven't gotten much production from him, but they remain in the lead.
Chicago making some changes. Luke Longley's checked in for Simpkins, and it's Harper in for Buechler. First team outside Kemp. Kerr against Wingate. Shrimp kicks to Peyton. 6 to shoot. Here's Kemp. That's in, coming off an assist from Peyton.
You know, tired legs can affect you at the defensive end, and I think that's what's happening right here.
I agree, because as much offense as we saw early, we're seeing even more of it here late. Tell you what, he can be really frustrating as a shooter. All you can do is grimace because he just can't find the range.
Shrimp passes to Wingate to the wing right side. The shot by Peyton, and another basket for Seattle. Now Harper. The step back jumper is good. And the Bulls lead by 7. Guys, some great passing from them.
Yeah, it makes it tough for the defense to chase that ball around when it moves that crisply all over the court.
Yeah, it sure does, Clark. And look at the assist totals. They're piling up. I mean, this has been a nice game execution-wise for this club.
And guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for Chicago?
Their defense has been outstanding, Kevin. Closing out on shots, blocking a lot of them as well.
And Steve, we can't fail to mention all the steals they've piled up too. I mean, that's making a big difference. They've really gotten into them defensively.
The Bulls making a switch here. Jordan's checked in.
He's done a much better job of getting to the line here. Aggressively taking it inside and not shying away from contact. I thought he was settling a bit in the first.
Second shot opportunity. There's big Luke Longley cleaning things up inside.
Well, that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active, be energetic, and react as soon as the shot goes up.
Here's Hawkins. Misses from close range.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
The drive by Jordan. He dishes it to Harper. On the wing, Kukoc. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will retain possession. Jordan up top. He's covered by Hawkins.
No breathing room at all to take that shot.
He feeds it to Shrimp. Johnson dishes to Kemp. From 13, he hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Kemp's got 9 points here in the second half.
His shooting has been so good today. He may have to take it upon himself to try to get his club out of this hole.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Well, Kevin, I was able to listen in on what the head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over.
Doris from the sideline.
Thank you, Kevin. I caught up with the Sonics head coach. I asked him about the challenge of defending this team, and he said, quote, it really comes down to their awareness offensively. They don't take a lot of bad shots or make those kind of mental errors, and that puts the pressure on us to be just as efficient. We've got to value our possessions so we can match them shot for shot. Gentlemen, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. It all sounds like a very solid plan given the shooters they have to contend with here, guys.
Yeah, he's aware of what their strength is, and he knows that they need to focus on stopping those guys.
Or at least limiting the damage they can do, Steve. Make it tough for them. Don't give them any easy opportunities. That, to me, might be a more realistic goal.
Here is Kerr after the made shot from Perkins.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
No, that's for sure, because this guy's too good of a shooter to miss that look consistently.
Askew passes to Perkins. Can't get it to go. And it's Chicago the other way. Now Kukoc. The shot misses. Nice D from McMillan. Rakowski. And they will get the basket here, folks, as they rule goaltending.
He almost got to that shot in time, but not quite. You can't touch the ball once it's on the way down.
8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Pass to Simpkins. Right at the free throw line. And it's off the back rim. No good. Sonics trail by 4. Here's McMillan. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Now here's Perkins from 13. The basket there by Sam Perkins.
And they have to mix it up defensively. That was just too easy.
Now Kerr. Takes a 3.
Oh, he got it!
Boom! Buzzer, knock it down!
Shot
right at the horn.
Boy, ends the quarter with a dead-eye 3 as the buzzer sounds.
They had that set up, I think, Steve, and he timed it perfectly.
No shortage of scoring here at the end of the first quarter. Bulls lead by 5. And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And taking a look at Chicago's performance here, Clark and Steve, what have they been doing or not doing?
And how about the defense, guys? They have really controlled the lane with their shot blocking.
Yeah, excellent defense there. Every shot has either been altered or rejected.
Gary Payton is out there with Hawkins. Then there's Sean Kemp. Then there's Perkins. And it's Shrimp in at the small forward position. They're the group for Seattle starting the second.
Well, as far as jump shots go, that's as high percentage as it gets.
I'm not sure how that didn't go down.
Perkins with the bucket.
You know, passing the ball well on the perimeter has really opened things up offensively for this club.
Steve, it makes the game easy. I mean, 10 straight points off assist. That's impressive, but it's easy when you move the ball.
Rejected by Jordan. And there's the pass to Shrimp. Another shot. He lays it in. Shrimp's got his first 2 points.
Boy, they are just destroying them in the paint.
You could say that again, Steve. The defenders just aren't aggressive enough down low.
The drive by Jordan. Pass to Harper. Outside Pippen. The three. Seattle grabs the miss. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Kemp kicks to Perkins. Rejected by Longley. And here is Rodman. Pippen for three. Perkins pulls it in.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Perkins with a screen on Harper. Payton kicks to Shrimp. It's stolen by Rodman. Here's Jordan. And he gets it to go. Jordan's got 8 points.
Can't pass up that kind of look.
Passes it to Hawkins. And that one's good.
You know, of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is major smash-mouth basketball, guys.
Love it. Old school. Just physical play in the paint. Dominate.
Here's Jordan. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. 10 points for him.
That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
Payton drives in. Boy, Gary Payton there with a heck of a move. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Jordan inside. He's covered by Hawkins. And Jordan gets it to go.
A large part of what they've been able to do here is centered around his offense.
Payton against Harper. Payton kicks to Kemp. Pass to Hawkins from downtown. It's all in by the Bulls. Rodman's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Jordan dishes to Harper. Rebound by the Sonics. Payton's got his 3rd rebound tonight. To the inside. Shrimp. There's the killer 2-handed slam. Stupendous rush to the rim and a mighty slam on the end of it.
But through the teeth of some pretty soft D. Can't help but say this.
Well, let's see how that impacts things here, because those kinds of plays sometimes can be game changers on both sides.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Well, Kevin, I was able to listen in on what the head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over in his huddle. He said, we're missing out on second chance points. He wants them going hard to the offensive glass for the rest of this game. He touched on was the physical aspect of this contest. He wants his guys using their strength and muscle to make things happen. Guys, they're clearly hoping those changes have an effect even before this game makes it to halftime. Kevin?
All right, Doris, thanks. And now we'll get a perspective here on the hustle game, how it's been going for the Bulls.
Well, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
And they're getting out in transition, too, finding some easy points on the fast break.
It's tipped. Here's Jordan. Lays it up and banks it in. Jordan's got the game tied up here for the Bulls.
And he's made the most of his chances, hasn't he? Really needs to continue to work for those good looks.
Here's the screen. The dish to Johnson. Here's Shrimp. Off target from outside.
Yeah, no excuses there. Got a really good look at the basket after being freed up by the pick.
We say it all the time. The execution was excellent. The result not as good, but good ball movement anyway.
And it's Steve Kerr knocking it down from long range.
You know what, guys? He can really light it up from the perimeter at times.
McMillan passes to Shrimp. Kerr against McMillan.
Probably should hold for one shot here. Clock is on their side.
Yeah, no brainer. They can hold it for the last shot.
Back to Jordan. With the fadeaway. A beautiful fadeaway jumper by Jordan.
They can't seem to do anything to slow him down.
Yeah, this is a scoring clinic. I mean, he's got it going on.
And we're through two here in a good one. It's Chicago. They're up by five. We're going to step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after our halftime.
Now, presented by Sprint.
Welcome to 2K Sports. It's been a great Sunday of basketball so far. Chicago with the lead against Seattle. Tremendous defensive effort out there. They're challenging every shot, sending them into the third row. An unbelievable half from Michael Jordan. High percentage looks in the first half. Amazing work from the field, shooting in the high 60s. That's big time bucket buy-in. And this dedicated Sonics team is weathering the storm. A dramatic advantage in the paint. They're getting right in close and converting the kind of buckets they want. They felt the impact of Sam Perkins. He's picked up half a dozen points and also helped out with two rebounds. That will be all for us. Thanks for stopping in. We'll see you next time.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. What a game we're seeing from Michael Jordan.
Yeah, it's been a lockdown defensive effort from him through the first two quarters. He's just swatting shots away.
Well, the reach and the timing he's shown to get to some of these shots has been really impressive. He looks like he has telescope arms out there. He's like an octopus.
Taking a look at the Bulls. We've got Longley. Dennis Rodman is out there with Pippen. And it's Michael Jordan. And it's Harper in at the point. Jordan kicks to Harper. Fires it up. No good. Payton with some nice D. Sonics trail by three. Rejected by Pippen. And they're able to recover. Seattle shooting their first shots from the stripe in this game.
Two shots.
And that one falls for Kemp. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Fast break. Here comes Chicago. Here's Pippen. He drains the quick shot. Pippen's got 9 points. Payton against Harper. That's tipped. Payton with the ball. Here's the teardrop. And it's good on the layup. Payton's got his second basket of the game.
Guys, that time you went.